The Great Gatsby is an American classic novel written by F. Scott Fitzgerald in 1925. It depicts an insightful view of the 1920s, also known as the Roaring Twenties and the Jazz Age. Fitzgerald uses this book to pinpoint various issues occurring during this time period: the prohibition, the change of women's role and existence of flappers, and the increasing gap between the high and middle class in terms of wealth distribution. Fitzgerald uses jazz music as the background music during Jay Gatsby's lavish parties. But when Baz Luhrmann, also known as the director of the modern Romeo and Juliet movie, transforms the book into a movie in 2013, the soundtrack is completely altered. The old-fashioned jazz songs were replaced by pop songs that rank high on music charts, such as Fergie's A Little Party Never Killed Anybody. Now in this video, I'll be presenting my two choices of songs that I think fit into two specific scenarios of the book. The first song that I chose is called This Is How We Do by the famous singer, songwriter, and actress Katy Perry. This song is very boisterous and exuberant, with a very bright and high tone and complex accompaniment that adds to the liveliness of the song. I felt that this song fully captured the moment where Nick arrives at Gatsby's party for the first time and all the partygoers are enjoying themselves naturally. Before moving specifically into how the lyrics relate to the novel, let's listen to the song first. Sipping on rosé, super late, sun coming up all lazy. Slow cooking pancakes for my boy, still up, still fresh as a daisy. Playing ping pong all night long, everything's on me, I'm then hazy. Chanel this, Chanel that, hell yeah, all my girls vintage, Chanel baby. It's no big deal, it's no big deal, it's no big deal, this is no big deal. This is how we do, yeah, chill and lay back, straight stunting, yeah, we do it like that, this is how we do.
The first line of this song is, sipping on rosé, sipping on sun, coming up all lazy, which not only portrays the YOLO mood of the scene, but also refers to one of the main cultural aspects of the time, the prohibition. Rosé is an alcoholic beverage, a type of wine which indicates the illegal beverages that were at Gatsby's party. During the prohibition, alcohol was illegal, but Gatsby was a bootlegger which enabled him to place alcohol on his party tables and gain wealth and status for himself. In Chapter 3, as Nick is describing the party, he exclaims, "In the main hall, a bar with a real brass rail was set up, and stocked with gins and liquors and with cordials so long forgotten that most of his female guests were too young to know one from another." The next portion says, "Slow cooking pancakes for my boy, still up, still fresh as a daisy." Now not only does this portion of lyrics also use the word Daisy, which is the name of a major character, but it also refers to Daisy's initial obedience to Tom as she is cooking pancakes for him. At this point in the story, when Nick first appears at Gatsby's party, Daisy and Gatsby have not met yet, therefore she is still completely loyal to Tom, despite his affair with his mistress, Myrtle. In The Great Gatsby, women are represented in the two main characters, Daisy and Jordan, the most. Daisy and Jordan are given relatively large roles and rights in the story, portraying the growing role of women during this time period. However, women are still not considered equals to men, and the subordination of Daisy by Tom represents this culture. Playing ping pong all night long, everything's on me and then hazy, portrays Gatsby's party. At his lavish celebrations, higher class people kept each other entertained by playing games such as ping pong and staying all night drunk and partying. Also, since there were alcoholic beverages that Gatsby acquired from bootlegging, the partygoers would get drunk or get hazy. Chanel this, Chanel that, hell yeah, all the girls been to Chanel baby, is another portion of the lyrics that depicts the partygoers. All the people that attend Gatsby's parties are rich, or at least pretend to be on the outside. Before at the party, all women would be dressed from head to toe in luxurious goods, including Chanel bags. For Gatsby, hosting these parties does not affect him much, because he is so wealthy. Also for the partygoers, they frequently attend his parties, so they do not consider his to be much different from others. Katy Perry sings, "It's no big deal, it's no big deal, it's no big deal, this is no big deal." Which shows that for everyone except Nick, who is new to the party, the grand party is not a burden or an irregularity in their lives. Readers are able to tell that Gatsby is enormously rich even before Chapter 3, when the party is described by Nick. In Chapter 1, Nick says that Gatsby's mansion had a tower on one side, spanking new under a thin beard of raw ivy, and a marble swimming pool, and more than 40 acres of lawn and garden. Now the second song that I think fits into The Great Gatsby is Unwell by Matchbox 20. This song would be a perfect match for the moment, so Gatsby is telling Nick about his true self that all other people do not seem to be interested in. The desolate mood of this song also reflects how Gatsby would have felt as he stared at the green light, waiting for Daisy his entire life. When Gatsby is telling Nick about his identity, we can tell that he is lonely yet content that he finally has a friend to trust. Before Nick becomes Gatsby's friend, Gatsby is portrayed as a loner, especially through this quote by Nick. As soon as I arrived, I made an attempt to find my host, but the two or three people of whom I asked his whereabouts stared at me in such an amazed way. This shows that even though there were countless people at Gatsby's parties, nobody really knew or even cared about who the host was. This is how the song Unwell goes. And talking to myself in public, and dodging glances on the train. And I know they've all been talking about me. I can hear them whisper, and it makes me think there must be something wrong with me. Out of all the hours thinking, somehow I've lost my mind. But I'm not crazy, I'm just a little unwell. I know right now you can't tell, but stay a while and maybe then you'll see a different side of me. I'm not crazy, I'm just a little impaired. I know right now you don't care, but soon enough you're gonna think of me.
The lyrics also fit Gatsby's situation as he is hopefully waiting for Daisy to return to the past. Matchbox 20 sings, "I'm talking to myself in public." At the end of the book, we can see that Gatsby, despite the number of guests at his parties, had no true friends. One of the main themes of The Great Gatsby is hope. It appears not only as Gatsby and many others are trying to achieve the American dream, but mostly when Gatsby is staring at the green light across the river. The green light serves as a type of color symbolism, representing Gatsby's hope to return to the past and be happy with Daisy. Since Gatsby spent his entire life around Daisy, he would have been alone and friendless whenever she was not with him. However, with these lyrics, readers can easily imagine Gatsby being alone and talking to himself because no one else is willing to listen to him. When Nick is at Gatsby's party for the first time, he hears numerous rumors about Gatsby and his past, none of which are true. In Chapter 3, some people say that he killed a man once, or he was a German spy during the war, but all from unreliable sources. Nick later finds out that Gatsby also knew about what people said about him at his parties, which is portrayed in the song with the lyrics saying, "And I know they've all been talking about me. I can hear them whisper." The lyrics, "And it makes me think there must be something wrong with me," makes the audience imagine Gatsby wanting to clarify his past while he hears rumors about himself at his party. But since no one was willing to listen to him, he was unable to do so. Realizing this, Gatsby must have faulted himself and tried to find what was wrong with him before trying to blame others. Throughout the novel, Gatsby is portrayed as a semi-loner because there were countless people that were his acquaintances, whether due to his parties or his bootlegging business. However, he did not have a true friend who was willing to listen to and trust him. The lyrics, "I know right now you can't tell," is the kind of message that Gatsby would want to say to Nick, because at first, Nick isn't able to see the truth in Gatsby. But later, Gatsby starts to open himself up more to Nick, so he actually wants to say, "But stay a while, maybe then you'll see a different side of me." Gatsby is currently in this stage of beginning to have faith in Nick, and soon he'll be able to tell Nick everything about himself, especially his past. Therefore, Gatsby wants Nick to stay until he is ready to reveal his past. Gatsby needs some time to fully trust Nick because he has never experienced an acquaintance with someone like Nick who is genuinely caring for and interested in Gatsby. The two songs, This Is How We Do and Unwell, fit different scenes of the novel, the exuberant party and the melancholic, hopeful moments respectively. The song lyrics portray the scene or character's feelings at a specific time in the novel. These songs accurately portray the scene and would be a part of my original movie soundtrack if I were to construct the movie. I hope you guys also approve of my two choices.